You ready to dive?
Let's do it.
All right, what's up, folks? Welcome to the Salt Divers Podcast. We are back. Dutch is back. Look at Dutch. Look at this guy.
What?
Freaking look dope. You look just like your thumbnail.
I do.
I know. You look great. That thing's real, too.
Just like my...
It's metal. Like,
well, yeah.
It's good.
It is.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah. Right. I want to see some Helldiver stickers and maybe like an Ace of Spades in the corner or something.
We're
going like
to do, you know, what is it?
Born to Kill.
What is it on the t-shirt?
Born to Kill or Born to Liberate.
Born to Liberate.
Yeah.
Do that on the side.
Yeah, man.
Get some stickers on there.
It'd be rad. You look good. You look good. Is that your new...
Hide your eggs. I don't know.
Okay.
It's like, if we're going to stream, you gotta get in character a little bit. That's what we're doing now.
You're falling into your...
Because right now I'm just like some fat potato-shaped guy who plays Helldivers, but I want to take it up another notch. I want to be a fat potato-shaped guy with some helmet on, glasses.
There you go.
And, you know, a little
Character. Yeah.
You know, if we're gonna make Dutch Butters a thing, he's gotta be a thing.
He's gotta be a thing. You look good though.
Yeah, I think I'm gonna get a flak jacket.
Sure.
Maybe some bullets.
Yeah.
We'll see. We'll evolve. We will evolve as we go along.
You're gonna be just in full gear.
Yeah, I'm gonna have to put on 80 pounds of gear to play a video game when we're all said and done. This thing's heavy.
It is heavy.
It's gonna be
I tried it on, it's way too big for me.
Yeah.
It's huge.
I'm surprised we found my helmet that fits my giant watermelon-shaped head.
Yeah, you were worried that it wasn't going to be
we're
going to fit. But anyway,
yeah.
Welcome, guys. We've got a grip of things to talk about today. The least of which is a new patch that just dropped this morning. The patches are back on Tuesdays, which is cool. Gives us something to talk about every week. So this is patch number 01-00403. And they just announced it this morning about 3 a.m. our time here on the West Coast. And there's a couple of interesting things in here. Apparently, the spear has been causing people to crash. I wasn't aware of that. I used it the other day, and it worked phenomenally. Like, I had a great time with that thing. It was awesome. It was targeting Bile Titans, like, spot on and taking them down with one shot. It's cool. But I guess it was causing crash issues. There's another one in here that I thought was kind of interesting, too, is that the Plasma Punisher... If you were wearing the shield bubble,
mm-hmm.
you couldn't shoot through your own shield bubble.
Yeah, I don't.
I don't really.
We don't play with that stratagem hardly ever. So I've never noticed that.
It's funny, like when everybody kind of like first got to level 20, mm-hmm. right? Like a couple months back, everybody was like, "Oh, the shield bubble!" Like everybody wore the shield bubble.
Yeah,
it was like a necessity for loadouts. But now I rarely see people use it.
Yeah, I used to use it a lot. I was talking. Yeah, I got my bubbles mixed up. But yeah, the personal bubble. There's the personal bubble, then there's the squad bubble.
Yeah, the big one.
You can put over computer terminals and things. But
nobody
uses that one either.
You know, the reason is, at least for me, it's like I'm never in one spot long enough to justify it. And bug side, it doesn't really do anything because they just bum rush you anyway.
Mm-hmm.
So they get inside the bubble and like, what's the bubble going to do? And then... For the bots, like, yeah, it's super useful against like rocket devastators and, you know, from things from a long range. But I'm not standing in one place when I'm fighting bots. I'm doing flanking maneuvers. I'm cutting across fields. I'm doing all kinds of crazy stuff. I'm not sitting in one spot. And it only lasts 30 seconds, which is not that long.
And after last night, the way the Hulks were sneaking up on me and killing me left and right, it was just there was no point. You just learn to run.
You got to move.
And I'm not very good at. I'm twitchy, but I don't run distances. I just kind of sit there and dance and spin around in a circle. I've eaten too many Rice Krispie treats at my
party. At your barbecue? Just bugged out.
Inside joke, guys. Inside
joke. It's an inside joke. There's one thing on here that I thought was interesting. They have now added the Japanese language voiceovers.
Oh, man, I'm so happy.
Which I'm like...
Don't get racist.
No, I don't want to get... No. But I'm just like, do you know how badass the Japanese language sounds? Like, have you ever seen like Star Wars?
Oh, yeah.
Like Darth Vader with Japanese...
When they get all upset.
It's so intimidating.
That sounds terrible. I'm sorry. But you know,
it's freaking badass, it's cool. Though. It's not racist. I think it's cool.
Like when they pull the swords out.
I wish I knew how to speak Japanese. That'd be dope. Can you imagine, like, for Super Earth, but like Japanese? I almost want to turn it on just to hear what it sounds like.
I kind of think I might.
Yeah.
Just for fun.
Cool. Your deck officer is, you know, just talking to you in like aggressive Japanese.
He's all like, not today. And, you know, whatever, whatever this is.
How's a cup of liberty? Like, I want that in Japanese, right? How freaking dope would that be?
All right. I'm not seeing nothing else on this patch. It's just like, you know, they got rid of the question mark fix or the bug.
It's, yeah,
the
for some.
Question marks, yes. That's super important. I'm very happy there's no more.
Sure, yeah. I mean, I didn't mind, you know, stumbling across a random question mark on Marfark once in a while. It would be like, oh, look, there's a big four-story purple question mark.
There's a
like,
bugged out neat. Rock right there. That's pretty cool.
So fix the issues with a spore spewer would appear purple on certain planets. I don't know. What's wrong with that?
Yeah,
purple. Is that a fix we need to work on?
Yeah.
Fixed peak physique.
This, that's probably a pretty big
That's a big one. That's a big one. I had assumed that it was working because I was like, wow, the aiming is so much better.
Well,
but then everybody informed me, like, well, actually, it doesn't work. And I'm like, well, did I just get better?
That's between us and
most other people.
Well, not most
some other people.
Just, you know, a small percentage of some other people who just, you know.
They have a notepad while they're playing. Let me just get the stats on this. I don't.
The glasses and the duct tape in the middle.
I don't worry about it, man. I thought it was working fine because my aim.
0.001% difference.
My aim was on point.
Nerd rage.
I love nerd rage.
Yeah.
Fixed issues where available operations were reset after player reconnected from getting kicked due to inactivity. Oh, that's okay.
See, these are issues.
These are all things that need fixed,
but are not.
A lot of them are not. Shouldn't be high priority. The high priority thing should be
the social tab,
the fishing, the social menu.
Which, didn't you have a?
I saw just this morning, that a piled stat, I believe, or Shams. I'm not sure which one made a. They answered a tweet, or maybe it was Twinbeard or something. I honestly don't remember, but I heard that they at least replied to a comment that asked about the social menu that said something along the lines of, excuse me, we have a guy working on it. He is deep in the code or something like this. And he's actually probably rewriting the whole social menu thing from the ground up. So
that's the biggest issue.
And that'll be a big issue when it finally happens. And I don't think it'll be too much longer.
Yeah.
Patience. Patience, young ones, patience.
I mean, for the most part, because I think it has something to do with crossplay. Because I almost exclusively play with PC players.
Right,
and that's not by design. It just happens to
be. But we play with the same people.
Yeah, I mean, the group of people that we play with are mostly PC players. And we rarely have issues. Maybe sometimes a couple hiccups here and there. It does happen. I'm not saying it doesn't happen. But
95% of the time, I'm fine.
Right.
But that 5%.
It's frustrating.
When something weird is going on, it's like, it's a complete system.
Because I'll notice, if I hop on, and I know for a fact somebody's on because we'll be talking on Discord, I'm like, oh yeah, I'm on right now, hop on. And I'll look, and it says they're offline, and I'm like,
Right.
It's stuff like that. It does absolutely need to be fixed, needs to be a priority.
My issue is I want to clean up my friends list. I want to dump some people and then bring other people on, and I can't do it. It just says, unfriend this person, boop. And
it doesn't do anything.
I'm like, I don't like that guy. Why is he on my
business? I don't like that guy. known issue. Here's an interesting one. Bile Titan sometimes does not take damage to the head. That's kind of an irritating issue. That'd be frustrating. Yeah. Superior packing mythology ship module does not work. That's true. And that was tested by our crew on Discord. We all went in. We were talking about, there was a big conversation in the chat. And then we all were like, well, you know what? Let's go check it out and see what's going on. And it was like, there was only like three weapons that actually the superior packing method applied to. The rest of them didn't do anything. We actually went through and actually game tested the game live together. Mm-hmm. And we were like, yep, this one doesn't work. Okay. And we'd back out. We'd start a new operation. We'd go in with superior packing. We'd dive. We'd use a different weapon. And we'd shoot it and then try to reload it and see what it would work. And yeah, so that's definitely on their menu.
Looks like they fixed some stuff. They got known issues list is way longer than the fixed issues list.
Yeah.
And they're chipping away at it. So
how many people do they have on their team?
I have no idea.
Like 12 people?
I don't know.
I don't know either.
I don't work there.
Bunch of Swedes. I hear they take really long vacations in the summer too.
Yeah, so. Like 6 weeks.
So like,
they all go out there and have children.
So, whatever. Just have fun playing a broken game.
They have big giant Swedish orgies out in the middle of the floor.
Whoa.
Isn't that what Swedes do? They all get naked.
No, I heard that.
Hang out with trolls and stuff.
I heard that Dutch Butters was the one who started that in Sweden.
Well, I mean, what else would I do? You go to Sweden with all those hot blonde people.
Yeah, man.
You know, like, hey, let's go.
Dutch Butters is in the house. All right.
Let's dive.
Let's dive. For Super Earth. Oh, my God. All right. mission count. Yeah, there's a bunch of stuff on here. Known issues is, like you said, it's bigger than the ones that they actually fixed. So let's hope that they get that taken care of in the next couple of weeks. We'll keep an eye on. If you do go to saltynerddiscord.com, we have linked the official update channel from their Discord to ours. So anytime they post like a big update or anything like that, the feed goes directly to our Discord. So that way you don't have to hop back and forth. All the information is in one spot for you guys. So if you'd like to join up, go to saltynerddiscord.com. We have a lot of really cool freaking Helldivers that are on all the time.
Really cool.
Really cool.
Cool.
Cool. I mean, yeah. I'm on there and Dutch is on there.
That's right.
And we have a grip of the A-team is there. Yeah. It's cool. All of our streaming friends. We got a lot of people in there that just play the absolute crap out of this game. Okay. What's the next topic we had? We had another thing. Oh, do you want to do loadout of the week, or is that too soon to do that?
Bro, we can do whatever you want.
I guess we can do whatever we want. Let's go to loadout of the week.
All right.
Let me scroll up. This was we picked one. This is from Whoppy Churro. Blade of Mercy. That's a badass ship name, by the way. We've got a new loadout. He said, this is my favorite.
Blade of Mercy?
That's what it says.
It's not as cool as Sword of War.
I mean, whatever, man.
Nobody has as cool a name as my ship.
Well, it's Dutch Butters' ship. You know what I mean? It might as well be called the Dutch Butters.
Ooh, that would be cool. I'll have to write Faustad about that.
Yeah, hey, man, can I name my ship something very special? It's not on the list. We have a new bot loadout for you guys. Call it the Decommissioner. Okay, all right. Primary, be rocking that sickle, which with that new sound effect, dude, I think is.
I love my sickle. I'm still using the sickle. It's great.
Yeah.
Great, great gun.
Secondary, of course, you got to run the Senator, that dirty, hairy, freaking six shooter.
Yeah, okay. I'm not gonna talk trash about
it. No, this is a good loadout. Impact grenades, of course, you have to. Those things are massively important. Armor passive was the servo assisted. So any armor that has the servo assisted basically allows you to throw your stratagems 30% farther with, trust me, in game, it makes a huge difference. You can throw a freaking eagle strike at a factory that's like 400 meters away and just it goes. Like that servo assist is real. For your stratagems, you're rocking the recoilless rifle. That thing is the goat. You can take down airships, gunships, hulks, factory striders. Like that thing is a heavy, heavy duty weapon. Orbital rail cannon. Classic. Yep. Takes down hulks in one shot. It aims itself. You don't have to think about it. Throw it. Walk away. Mm-hmm. Boom. Done. The walking barrage. This one you do have to be careful with.
Yes, you do.
I've killed a couple people.
You killed me a few times.
I killed a couple people with the walking barrage. Because this is actually the first time I've ever used it. I've never used the walking barrage before. I like targeted things. I like things that like go in one spot.
Yeah.
I don't like the big barrages. I don't like the 380s. I just don't. They're too.
Get out of the way.
Yeah. It's like clear.
There's a barrage coming in. It's like, no.
Like clear the map, I guess. Get out of the way. And then, of course, your classic Eagle Airstrike, which is super awesome now that they buffed it. This is a great loadout. I had a lot of fun fighting some bots on this one. And it was fairly close to the loadout that I already use for bot side anyway. I like to use the tenderizer more than the sickle just because I feel like it has a little bit more pinpoint accuracy. The sickle is great for that, like just unloading an entire and you just keep going. You don't have to reload. Yeah. It's phenomenal for that. But I like it.
I've been rolling with a lot of lasers here lately.
Yeah, what do we call that?
I think I'm gonna change up my style a little bit. I think it's like a Star Wars
loadout. Star Wars just laser everything. Laser backpack.
Guard dog laser.
Yeah.
Laser shoulder mounted laser cannon in my sickle. It's fun. It melts bots, but
have you ever used the servo assisted armor?
Just a little bit.
Okay.
Just a little bit.
For the loadout for testing this out, I used the one that has the 50% limb health. You can take a lot of abuse.
Yeah.
For a fairly light armor or relatively light armor, you can take a lot of damage with that limb health thing. It's got the big shoulder pads. Yeah. You're like walking around. It's cool. Thank you, Whoppy Churro.
Yep.
Blade of Mercy. I like that. I like Blade of Mercy. It's good.
It's like, oh, I'm sorry. You have some mercy.
Yeah, yeah. It's like you're putting them out of your misery yeah. or out of their misery with yeah. the Blade of Mercy. It's like Sting from Lord of the Rings. You know what I mean?
All right.
Like, just. Speaking of knives, dude.
You like the throwing knife?
Bro, I've been getting good at those.
Are you?
Yeah.
All eight of them you get?
Ten.
Ten? I thought
yeah,
it was
you get
eight.
Ten. Well, maybe because I use the packing loadout thing.
I actually haven't used it yet.
No?
No.
It takes a little bit to get used to. You'll be throwing it and they'll just go mm-hmm. in random places. Because the little dot on your screen,
yeah.
it's not where the knife goes.
No.
It goes like up and to the right a little
bit. Oh, it's got the old the left-handed missile launcher glitch.
Yeah.
Is that what it is?
It goes up and to the right. Like, so if okay. you're going to throw it,
it's like, oh.
You got to like aim down a little bit and then it hits him in the head. It's really cool. I mean, once you get used to it, it's fine. Like, whatever. But I actually took down a Hulk with it.
Nice.
It took three or four knives to the back vents and it killed okay. the Hulk. And I was like, oh, shit. All right.
Yeah.
It's nice. Good. Sometimes it doesn't do anything.
It just bounces off.
Just bounces off. Clank. Oh, I don't know if I'm going to be able to pull the clip or not, but it did. Christ was using him.
Uh-huh.
And he threw it at a bot, and it bounced off the armor, and it hit him in the face, and he died.
What?
Instantly.
It was killed himself with a throwing knife?
It was freaking hilarious, dude.
I didn't even know that was possible.
From my point of view, I just see the knife go, and it goes, scoop. And it just falls right back on. It just spins right back at him.
Oh, I love that kind of stuff about this game.
It was so funny.
Yeah, it's really good.
He's like, oh my God, I just killed myself with a knife. It's awesome. So okay. one of the topics I wanted to kind of talk about was this game's difficulty levels.
Yeah.
But people are still talking about this, how much, oh man, this game is so hard. And I was looking at Pylestead's tweets recently, uh-huh. and he had some interesting points of view that I think are important for gaming. He was responding to somebody. I believe he's talking to somebody about Elden Ring, mm-hmm. which is notoriously like a just insanely difficult
game. Yeah.
It's not something that I'm going to spend my time playing, no. but a lot of people love it. And the reason why I think people talk about it so much is because it's so difficult that it's not like a casual pickup game. Like, you got to be on point. And that's part of the thing is like, I mean, they require, his tweet here says, they require focus and patience, something we have kind of forgotten mm-hmm. about in this day and age. And I agree. Like, if you have a game that's just like, just a walkthrough, easy, playable right. game or whatever, like, yeah, it's fun and you can kind of turn your brain off a little bit, but you don't get that satisfaction. And
well, it just depends. There are times when I just want to go into a game
yeah.
and relax. You know, I mean, I've mentioned many times I used to play WoW.
Yeah.
I don't play WoW anymore, World of Warcraft. But you made fun of me once because I said, it's kind of nice to just, you know, get home from work, log into my game, go to winter, spring or whatever,
mm-hmm.
and go fishing for an hour.
Yeah.
And you're like, lame.
That's boring.
It's boring. It is. It is boring as hell. But, you know, you can sit there, you know, come home, crack open a beer, pull out your fishing pole and go, zoop, and click your mouse for an hour and drink and chill, you know, and you might bring up something cool out of the swamp or whatever.
Yeah.
But that's completely opposite of what this game is. This game is this is an adrenaline junkies game. This is a game that you play to get that built up, pent up aggression out. You know, that's what I like about this game. It's just not that type of a game. It's not a hang out on the dock and
fish
up stuff.
Actually, this is a great tweet that Pylestead just put out. He was responding to somebody who was talking about the difficulty levels and if we're ever going to get like a difficulty 10.
Mm-hmm.
He says, this game, Helldivers 2, aims to evoke different emotions.
Yeah.
Edge of your seat gameplay. Yep. This turns into epic wins or epic fails.
That's right.
Shared laughter or collective fuck yes.
Mm-hmm.
And every time I jump on this game, all of those things.
That's exactly what we're getting.
Exactly what we're getting.
And I love it.
Yeah. And I always remember of like back in the day, I used to play like the original Tomb Raiders and stuff like that on PS1.
Mm-hmm.
And like even like the old Nintendo Mario games where right. you're like, you finally get to Bowser and you take 4 days
yeah.
to play the same level because you keep dying. And eventually you finally freaking win. And then you're like, yes. Mm-hmm. And you just get, that's that emotion that these games are supposed to be invoking. It's right. not supposed to be a walk in the park. So I appreciate the fact that this game has all these different difficulty levels. Like I gave my middle kid, he's only 6. I put him on a difficulty.
No.
Just said, here, man, here's difficulty 1 on bug side. So he's just going to be shooting little crickets. And I'm like, have at it, bud. You're good. And he just...
Nice.
You know, like that game has the option to be that walk in the park. But if you want to get that emotion, you want to get that like group, like, yes, we freaking did it. Like you bump that sucker up to 8, 9, and 10 or 8, 9 or whatever. I guess I don't know if 10's coming out. Don't quote me on that. 7, 8, 9 and you get that feeling.
Yeah.
And that's why I like the game. That's why I jump in every day, is because I'm looking for that. I'm chasing that adrenaline rush. And I want those clippable moments. I want that moment where I can like, oh man, I'm so glad I freaking recorded that. Yeah. You know, we could post it online and share it with our friends and Discord and do all kinds of stuff. So that's what this game does, man. And I think
it's even more fun when you actually figure out how to do some things. You know, I mean, there is something to be said. You can definitely put on a lower level and go down and do your dailies and get your 15 medals and stuff. That's fine. But when you're sitting there with your group and you got on like a 7 or 8 and you're doing like a Helm's Deep, you know, defend the motor, defend the engine thing here, you know. And also all four of us have, there's 16 different freaking sentries out there. And you're just standing up on the ledge, just going, let's go, bring it on. And you got your rocket sentries just going crazy.
Shooting airships down out of the sky.
It's awesome. It's an awesome sight to behold.
Yeah.
And he's just like, wow, this is really cool. It's like, yeah. And once you figure out how to do some of these things, it's super fun.
Yeah.
But Helm's Deep in particular is just super satisfying to me right now. So
the last subject that we kind of wanted to talk about was the honeymoon phase of this game.
Yeah.
So we've seen player numbers drop steadily on Steam. I don't know what they are on PlayStation, but on Steam, they're steadily kind of going down. Every once in a while, we'll get a pop when a new patch comes out.
Yeah, so I think the numbers are low because of all the issues they've had, you know, some of them, and, you know, the big issues with the worldwide thing where a lot of people still can't play and everything that's affected the game. And I don't think they ever really fully recovered from that,
from that fiasco, the Sony thing. Yeah.
But I still believe this game is going to get better over time, and people just have to give them time to do it. But these kind of games, they do these peaks and valleys. Every time something new is released, the numbers go up a little bit, then it goes back down. Until something new is released, you know, it's the typical graph.
Yeah.
You know, up and down, up and down. And I get it. It's fine. It's the problem is the peaks are getting lower.
Yeah.
And lower and lower. And
that's okay. Honestly, I think it's okay. Yeah. Because if we have a, let's just say on PC side, I'm not going to mention PlayStation numbers because I don't know what they are. But I know for a fact the PC numbers are around the 40 to 50,000 mark.
Yeah.
On any given day. Mm-hmm. And then it's higher on the weekends and it's lower during the week.
I think they were down to like 16,000 or something.
Really? That low?
Yeah.
Whoa.
But,
well, it's a work week.
Yeah.
But I don't necessarily think, I mean, obviously I want as many people to play this game as possible, but I don't necessarily think having like a foundation of 20 to 40,000 players at any given time. And that's just going to be your typical level of who's going to play the game for a long period of time. You're going to have your hardcore fans.
Yep.
Your players that play every week, whether it's just on the weekends or if they hop on for an hour a day, whatever.
Yep.
But to have that foundation of like 30,000 people who just play every day, I don't necessarily think it's a bad thing. Because those are your hardcore fans. Those are the people who want to dive, who want to have fun, who are invested in the story. Whatever story it might be. I mean, one of the issues I know a friend of mine has is like, well, there's no point. Like, there's no campaign. There's no end of the story. There's no end. It's just, in my head, I kind of make my own story up.
Right.
And I'm like, oh, shoot, you know, we're getting attacked on this planet over here. And in my head, I'm like, okay, we got to defend this planet. And then we're going to work our way this way. And it's like,
I have thought about that.
Yeah.
It's like we're in a never ending war cycle. Mm-hmm. And we're still missing a faction, maybe two factions that are going to be coming out of this game. And, you know, the game is set in a world where the war, it doesn't end, it just evolves. I mean, you can't have a game without the war.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah, if we beat the automatons, what are we going to do?
But, you know, my biggest issue, I think, with the game is just, I don't like it when major orders are failed.
Yeah.
I think that's a waste. I know they're prepared for them to fail. They just, you know, change the narrative a little bit, you know, we move on to a different thing. But it doesn't feel like they're making adjustments for the reduced player base? Is like, are we playing major orders that are designed for 100,000 players with 55,000?
Yeah.
You know, a third of which refuses to play on one side or the other because I only play bots or I only play bugs. Fuck that other side. It's too hard. You know, it's just, that's the stuff I get frustrated with.
Sure.
You know, so I don't know if Joel is tweaking the numbers a little bit to make it so that it's more balanced as far as
how many people are actually playing.
Right.
Yeah.
So,
and there's got to be an incentive. I think one of the issues, not issue, but just one of the ideas I have is like, okay, I do feel like there has to be some kind of a end goal reward. Mm-hmm. So like if we start fighting on the automatons, let's just say we have like four major orders.
You mean like tank mines?
Yeah. Let's say we have like four major orders on the automaton side and we're actually beating them back and we're taking planets and we're down to just like one last sector of space that, and there's like one last planet and we all like collectively, okay, everybody has to go to that planet. The planet's like just it's like Malevolent Creek all over again.
Yeah.
Just insane numbers of bots. We're getting the shit beat out of us, but we take that last planet. And the automatons are by all means beaten.
Mm-hmm.
I feel like having that like collective, oh, we can actually wipe them off the map and then we actually do it.
Mm-hmm.
And it's like a celebration and we don't have to fight bots anymore for a little while. Like they're gone until the next invasion comes in. They try to start fighting back.
Yeah.
But I feel like there has to be that like, yes, we freaking did it. We finally took them out. We liberated all these planets and these are all ours now and yada, yada, yada. And then we get attacked by a different faction from another part of the area. You know what I mean? I do feel like it needs to have that, like,
I mean,
final win.
If we can't have a final win.
Not like forever. Just like just we like, have to
hey,
have
good
a
good job, guys. Go play a Call of Duty now.
No.
We'll reinvade in a couple months after we speak the code. It's like, okay.
We have to have that incentive. Like, we actually did win.
Yeah.
And now the Illuminate are here and we have to fight them for a little while.
Yeah.
But the bots are gone. Like, they're gone for a while. Now we have to refocus on this side of things. You know what I mean?
Yeah, I get you.
And then, like, eventually they'll work their way back and they're like, hey, we're hearing rumbles. Because I want to have that, like, almost like that, like you're missing it. Like, oh man, I remember we took that freaking last planet from bots. I haven't fought bots in a while. And
yeah.
I wonder, and you start getting those like
and you
little,
go back and they look different.
Yeah, yeah. They come back and they're like slightly evolved and they've got like different types of units and you're like, oh, okay. Like it doesn't have to be a different faction. It just needs to be something, okay. Well, they lost that whole war and they got pushed all the way back to their territory. Now their second advance, they have all these new weapons and all these new stuff and all this new whatever.
Yeah.
I think that'd be kind of cool. I don't know if they're gonna
the game and the story has to evolve
over
time. It just can't simply be We liberated Malevolent Creek, then we lost it. Then we liberated it again, then we lost it. Then we liberated it. Yes, it's just, it needs to, something new needs to happen once in a while. Uh-oh, you got a look on your face. What just happened?
Twinbeard just tweeted at me.
At you?
At me.
Nice.
I tweeted 2 days ago. Uh-huh. I said, hey, Palstead and Twinbeard, could we get World War II style paint jobs on Pelican 1 in the future?
Oh, cool.
Thank you. And he tweeted me, he says, it would indeed be cool. I call dibs on bearded vengeance.
Nice.
Dude, that's awesome.
Like old style, like pinup
girls. Yeah, like
girl
pinup.
Type.
Like pinup girls. That's what I posted online. Yeah. You can see my tweet. What's my name? Salty1138 on X.
That's cool.
That's freaking rad, dude.
Right on.
I'm going to tell him right now. Like, bro, I'm recording our podcast.
You want to come on?
I would love to have those guys on, dude.
That's funny. Good thing you have an edit button.
I'm not editing this. I'm applying to this motherfucker right now. So, holy crap, I'm literally in the middle of recording my weekly podcast for Helldivers. And you, the great Twinbeard.
Oh, God. Don't
don't do that.
Don't.
Okay.
don't kiss his ass that much. And you tweeted us out. Thank you. Or
that's badass.
That's funny.
Thanks, man. For super, Earth. I don't know, whatever.
Yeah, big salutes. Dorky.
I'm just gonna put salutes.
Yeah, you really like a salute emoji. It's good stuff. I like
you
it.
Do a squad of four, man. It's good That's rad, dude.
Nice.
That's cool.
Nice.
Twinbeard just tweeted at me. That's awesome. Yep. What else we got, man?
I don't know. Kind of a slow week.
Yeah, it's, well, I don't know if it's been slow. I mean, there's been a lot of issues with the new patch.
Yeah.
Okay, final thoughts. I want to do something real quick about the Viper Commando Warbond.
Okay.
It was one of the cooler Warbonds that's come out, right? How often do you use any of that stuff?
I've kind of just yesterday I kind of exited out of the Viper stuff and moved into to the armor I really like.
Yeah.
So
yeah, same.
Yeah.
I was wearing the sleeveless heavy armor for a while and I was having a really good time with it. But I reverted back to my classic armor that I always use, the one that you comment. You're like, man, that's a badass looking armor. Like, it's the red.
I did the same.
Extra padding with the explosive damage reduction thing.
I did the medium armor with the engineering kit. I like the +2 grenades.
Yeah.
And I went back with the matching hooded armor helmet that it's not in the same set, but it still matches really
good. Yeah.
It's just the look I like. I'm not an aesthetics guy. I like to look cool.
Exactly. However, there's a thing to that. Like, I love the way the Viper Commando stuff looks,
but
That explosive reduction on the armor is so important for bot side. I can't really play without it because you can take a freaking rocket devastator to the face, get flipped and ragdolled and pick yourself up, stem and go back to war. Any other armor that I use that's not heavy, forget about it.
Yeah.
You're dead instantly. So
I do want
to. We have our, mention, I think we always revert back to like that one set.
We have our set.
We have our set.
Yeah. That's what I did last night. But I do want to mention, last night we were playing, we played for like 3 or 4 hours last night, and we were on level 6.
Mm-hmm.
It did not feel like a level 6.
No, no, it did not. That was rough.
That was ridiculous. I died 7 times in that last mission we did. It was stupid.
Yeah. Well, the airships don't help.
No.
Those freaking goddamn gun airship things that pop out of that factory. Like,
yeah.
God, if you do not immediately.
You have to go take that thing out.
You have to immediately attack that thing because
number one priority.
Yeah. If they release 2 or 3 of those things, you're freaking cooked.
Unless all 4 of you bring laser cannons to take out those things.
Yeah. I was literally, I had to go pick up somebody else's.
That was
gear who died.
Yeah.
That I could fight the airship.
I'm like my 5th death.
Because I'm like, I didn't pack anything to fight airship. I'm like, let me go rob somebody's dead body real quick. Yeah, it's legit, dude. But yeah, anyway, that's been the 30-minute podcast for today, actually. We're out of our time. So thank you. What is it? Wobbly Churro? Is that what it was?
Woppy Churro.
Woppy Churro for the loadout of the week. Appreciate it, guys. Make sure to comment below your favorite armor set loadout that you kind of revert back to. Like, no matter what Warbond's out, you'll always go back to the classics. Right. Let us know what it is. I'm curious.
I just wanted to say one thing really quick. Remember, guys, we play games to have fun.
Yeah.
Have fun.
Have fun with it.
Don't be completely angry and crazy all the time. Let the devs have time to do their thing and try to enjoy the game. And if you can't enjoy the game, take a little break, come back in a week or two and see if you still got it. See if you still have that fire for the game. Because nobody wants to play games that you're not having fun at. So,
all right, bro.
Nice. Nice helmet. Let's go. Let's get out of here.